It's probably not so surprising that the situation that we have earlier, this is in fact a linear transformation. And because it is a linear transformation, that means it can be written as a matrix. This thing can be written as a matrix. In other words, if I let vector AB be the current population in country A and country B, so I have vector A and B here where my little a, this is the current population in country A, so this is going to be the number of people in country A this year. And my B, this is the number of population in country B this year. I can think of what happened from year to year as a function, as a linear transformation that sends this vector AB to some other vector. Let me actually use a pink vector here, where the numbers here are going to be the number of population in country A next year and the number of population in country B next year. And we're going to see in a moment, but because this F is a linear transformation, so that means I can write this thing as just a matrix multiplication. And to find the entries of my matrix, I can just think of it as column by column, where the first column is going to be just f of 1, 0. Whatever this is, that's going to be the first column of my matrix. And then to find the second column, I just need to find f of 0, 1. Whatever this is going to be the second column of my matrix. And what is f of 1, 0? F of 1, 0 means if I have 1 people in country A and no one in country B this year, what is going to be the population next year? Well, I can pretend momentarily that 10% of people from country A move to country B. So if I only have 1 people here, I'm just going to pretend that, well, 10% of that, which is 0.1 people, will move and remain in country B, whereas 0.9 people will be in country A. So this is going to be the first column of my matrix here, 0.9 and 0.1. And then f of 0, 1, that means I only have 1 people live in country B, and because 30% of people will migrate to country A, so that means out of this 1 people, 0.3 people will move to country A and live in country A next year, and then 0.7 will remain in country B. So my second column here is going to be just 0.3 and 0.7. And actually, this is it. My function f, what happened from year to year, is just the same as multiplying by this matrix. If I multiply this matrix by a vector AB, what I'm going to get? Let's see what I'm going to get. I'm going to have 0.9 times A plus 0.3 times B. So I'm going to have 0.9 times A plus 0.3 times B. And then I'm going to have 0.1 times A. 0.1 times A plus 0.7 times B. This pink vector is going to be the populations in country A and country B next year. To see why this makes sense, let's think of the general case then. Let's say if I look at the number of population in country A and country B, and I have little a and little b in country A and country B respectively. And because 10% of people from country A will move to country B, so what that means is 0.1 people, 0.1A will move to country A, and then 0.9A will remain in country A. And out of this B people, 30% will move to country A, so that means 0.3B will move to country A, and then 0.7B will remain in country B. So in the next year, I'm going to have 0.9a plus 0.3b, 0.9a plus 0.3b, b in country A, and I'm going to have 0.1a plus 0.7b, I'm going to have 0.1a plus 0.7b, b in country B. And notice that this is actually the same number that we see from earlier. So in the situation in the earlier example, what happened from year to year is the same as multiplying by this matrix here. And notice that what we have here is kind of the same as what we put into Python earlier as well.